I find myself starting this episode in a very small town called Cooke City, Montana. With a population of only around 200 people, Cooke City sits towards the northeast entrance of Yellowstone. After a long day of exploring the park last time, in this episode, we work our way back down through the park and end our day in the Tetons.
Well, good morning from Yellowstone, day two here. We have ourselves a good old-fashioned little bison block to start the day here as we're kind of moving through the park. Look how big these guys are. These guys are just absolutely huge. Oh. Welcome back to another episode of season two of the vlog. We're gonna be cruising through and see if we can catch some more wildlife this morning in the Lamar Valley. It was a pretty chilly night last night. Frost on the ground, frost all over Luna, probably down in the 20s to sleep, but it was actually rather comfortable. The magnitude of this place and just the size and scale is something that's kind of hard to understand without seeing it yourself. So the fact that these bison like don't get cold and they're just out here year round is pretty incredible. And just a few minutes later, we have ourselves another bison block here. There's quite a few bison all up this hillside and they're just kind of scattered between the road and either side. So I guess we kind of just wait for them to to do their thing. Guys, I can successfully say that I've seen a wolf. It was a quick experience, but it was cool to see nonetheless. I had just kind of been making coffee and shooting some time lapses when all of a sudden everyone's kind of interest switched. I saw what looked like to be almost like a dog running through the valley in between these bison and stuff like that. So I quickly had to do like a lens change. And by the time I really got to him, the wolf was far enough away that it was kind of hard to see, but I still think wolves are probably one of like the crown jewel of wildlife to see out here in Yellowstone. The plan is to head into where the geysers are, kind of like Old Faithful, stuff like that, and then also head out to Yellowstone Lake and just have another beautiful day and enjoy myself, be happy, have fun. Thanks for riding along. Time to hit the road. The first stop this morning is a super popular area called Mammoth Hot Springs. I've been here once before, but it was very briefly. It's nice because they build all like these boardwalks. Well, I have to, because if you fall in here, I'm sure you just dissolve. Mammoth Hot Springs, stop number one. Yellowstone is actually like on top of like this huge volcano, apparently, where if it erupted, it would like cover like four states or something crazy. Like we'd all be doomed. The smell is just so strong of like rotten eggs, that sort of sulfur hot spring smell. And it's so cool to see this stuff in person, see the colors, the water, the grass. Like definitely recommend taking a stroll around the hot springs if you're ever here.
feels like I've been driving around just about like all morning, all day long, just because this place is so incredibly big that I figured just pull over and just chill out for a little bit and just enjoy this absolutely marvelous view of this river. There's a bison in the distance, some ducks in front of me. It's so easy to want to go do like the really big, like best things to do. But I think also sometimes just sitting and enjoying something as simple as the river with an amazing view, I think is just as good, if not better sometimes. So especially when it's such a crowded place, crowded day, the Sunday Memorial Day weekend, this is just a nice little escape. Kind of my own little oasis right in front of me. These cars are for, but it must be some sort of hike or spring because this line is crazy long. Look at this. What is this for? Oh god, this is an atrocious parking setup. There's even more cars on the other side here. They just don't end. That line was for the Grand Prismatic Spring, which is what I was going to do. I should have known better because it's like right in the middle of the day, and that's one of the main highlights of Yellowstone in general. So I'm going to skip that because I passed the boardwalks and it just seemed like literal zoo of people. I think I'm gonna try to work my way to Yellowstone Lake, but I am by far in the most busiest section of the park. I think I'm about to pass like the parking and all that stuff for Old Faithful, which is arguably probably the biggest attraction. Oh my god, there is so many cars. Wow, where's everyone going? Am I missing something? How are they even fitting everyone in there? That gives me a ton of anxiety. Fast forward about an hour and a short 10-minute nap. I'm gonna find myself on a short little trail to a place called Duck Lake. I'm in the Devil's Thumb part of the park, which is where Yellowstone Lake is. There seemed to be a really cool other little section, so I decided to get out, go for a little walk. So I don't know why I've been like taking naps. Took a nap yesterday and took a nap today. Kind of the last of our explorations of Yellowstone before we start to head down to Jackson Hole and the Tetons. Well, I'm really bright. Absolutely beautiful day, great hiking weather. I must say, I'm a bit surprised that I'm the only one at this lake. One thing I certainly miscalculated this trip in Yellowstone is just how long it takes to truly move around the park. I had an idea of the mileage and how the distance, but just in terms of how the road drives, the traffic, the wildlife, definitely miscalculated that part, but it's all good. So it is currently 5:07 and I just kind of got done exploring this West Thumb area. So I think it would probably make the most sense to begin to head down to the southern end of the park, a little bit closer to Jackson, and explore along the way there, and then hopefully make some sort of sunset plan kind of in that end. But it probably would make sense around this time to start to work our way down. Super sad to say goodbye to Yellowstone. I'm grateful I get to come. I'm so happy I made the trip, but I'm also just like frustrated that I even have to leave as quick as I did. Like 2 days is not even close to beginning to have enough time here, but let's enjoy the southern end, appreciate it for what it is. Made it out here to
Grand Tetons just outside Jackson Hole, and my goodness, is this gorgeous. When I was driving in, there was a huge traffic jam. I'm talking like just cars lined the road either way, cops like pulling in and out, people all over the sidewalk, and there was a pretty big grizzly bear that we were able to see. So right as I got in here, I couldn't see anything at first, but I was like, when there's this many people, you gotta stop. So I found a quick spot, and the bear actually got so close that the national park people were yelling at everyone to get in their car, and the bear actually ended up crossing the street. So far this weekend, we've seen bison, we've seen a wolf, we've seen bear, we've seen elk, basically everything except for some moose. Probably one of the most beautiful places in Teton, one of them at least, the Oxbow Bend turnout. Look at this view behind me. You're right down on the Snake River, and it's just an amazing place to watch the sunset, or sunrise for that matter. I mean, that basically looks fake, does it not? How beautiful. Let me give you guys this. Look at that reflection. We have Luna parked up there, but I mean, it doesn't get much better than this. This is incredible. Look at that reflection. Oh my God. Just like that, we have reached the end of another day here, this time in beautiful Oxbow Bend and Grand Teton National Park. And it was just one of those incredible evenings into the blue hour. We are not much to say at a place this beautiful, to be honest. I feel like during the day I lose like some juju, lose some inspiration. I take a nap. I don't know if just because like the light isn't as good and there's tons of people out, but like the sunrise and the sunset parts of the day, I am just like completely just like in the zone and just fired up. Because stuff is so beautiful. I think that's okay. Probably just gonna hang out here for a little bit, make some dinner, and then figure out what we're gonna do to sleep, but absolutely beautiful. I drove back towards Jackson, probably about 20 minutes up a road called Antelope Flat Road or something, and I found this little pullout and no signs or anything, so I think I'm just gonna crash here for the night. It is totally pitch dark. I don't know why I'm showing you guys this, but this is basically where I'm sleeping, just off the side of the road.